Welcome to the Great Exodus series. God's plan of rescue for his children. Let my people go. The path to Mount Zion. My name is Michael and I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And today our topic will be a kingdom heart. But before we start, please subscribe, share, like our videos, and not only this video here or the videos of the Great Exodus series, but also our daily prophetic words, our videos in the New Journey to Paradise series, and the mini-series that we produce for Patreon. The mini-series you can watch when you are a patron of Triple Grace. Think about this, to become one. It's only $5 a month. Help us to spread the message through social media and everywhere so that people have an understanding what will happen right now, that the escape of the bride will take place and then the seals will be opened, and then that they have an understanding what will happen when the seals are opened, what will come onto earth, how many disasters will come, will the Antichrist do, what about the mark of the beast. All these questions are answered in one of our videos called The Most Important Video of Your Life. Have you seen it? If not, watch it. There is a folder, a playlist folder, that keeps three videos in this Most Important Video of Your Life series. Watch them and join us. Sign up to be a member of Triple Grace. It's a website, triple-grace.com. Very simple, just an email password and then you become a member. Then you have access to all the resources, all the videos, all the training materials. And then you can walk forward in confidence on the straight and narrow path in the middle to Mount Zion. And for all the people who are guided by the Holy Spirit and who have an understanding that this message is very, very important, and has to go forth into the nations. For these people who are willing to help us financially with a donation, all the links are in the description box below. And if you want to use PayPal, you can find it in the right top corner of our YouTube channel. Please just click there and make your donation. It will help us greatly to spread the messages to all nations. Sisters in our mission to Cambodia, 97% there are falling false gods and idols. These are pearls that are still in the dragon layers, and now we have to take them out and bring them to the Father. Many people need to be rescued there. And do not forget that your purpose is to win souls, and for that purpose you can establish a society of the rose, an assembly of love and righteousness in your neighborhood, to gather the people together, so that you can fully concentrate on the heavenly kingdom, and not anymore on the world or on Babylon. Because only if you walk in true harmony, you will walk that middle path, that narrow path, towards the holy mountain, towards the Lord, towards the Father. Now let us return to the topic today. A kingdom heart. What is a kingdom heart? A kingdom heart is a heart that is beating for the heavenly kingdom only, that has overcome the world and overcome Babylon. For me, Babylon represents any false religion, any false denomination, any false teaching, anything that is standing against the heavenly kingdom. Where people claim they can forgive sins, where people claim you have just to sit and wait because you are once saved, always saved, all this false teaching, including of prosperity gospel and poverty gospel. You just only have to open your Bible and read it one time to understand that all their claims are false. They're picking Bible verses out of context and then they present it to make a case. And all this is only to lull you into sleep so that you remain sitting in your church benches. Use your money for the church leader to have a Rolls Royce or a plane. This is wrong. And you will never become rich through that purpose. If they tell you, oh, you have to give and then you get 1 million back. All a lie. All is a lie. It is not about the world. It is not about money. It is not about the denomination, not about religion, not about anything like that. It is all about the heavenly kingdom and the love of the Father. When Jesus was on earth, he walked. Every step he did, he always said, I do what my Father has commanded me, and I show forth his love for his creation. That is what it's about, the love of the Father, and to do the work in his name, and not in your own. You do it in your own name, you're part of the beast system, you're part of the world, and you're part of Babylon. But if you step out of it and make your own society of the host, and do everything in the name of the Father, and show forth the love of the Father into your neighborhood by lifting up the needy, by helping the poor, by looking for the Lazarus at your gates, by reducing suffering, by inviting the people to come to your society of the host, to come your meetings, and then maybe to establish a second one and a third one, because there should be not more than 50 people in one society of the Rose. If you need more information about societies of the Rose, we have a big video in our New Journey to Paradise series, only dedicated to societies of the Rose. Just watch it. All the resources are at your fingertip. Just use them. Watch them. Share them. Discuss them. Ask questions. Send me your question to triplegrace55@gmail.com. And I will answer for you immediately. I'm here for you. And I love you all dearly. Now, do you have a kingdom heart? A heart that is beating for the kingdom? Or is your heart still in the world, in your career, in your, even in your family, in your daily life? Or is your heart already outside of the world and outside of Babylon and beating for the kingdom, advancing the kingdom, showing forth the love, doing everything in the name of the Father? Kingdom heart is required so that you can shine forth as Jesus did and walk as Jesus did and act as Jesus did. And if you do that, then you become a true son of the living God, a true son of the Father. And only then you are a co-heir of Jesus Christ. Because he said the only way is to come through me. That means he is the son of the Father. So if you want to to come to the Father, you also have to be a son or daughter of the Most High. And this you can only become if you walk as Jesus did. So then, what did Jesus do? What did he do? He was out there winning souls every day. He was out there declaring the kingdom of heaven. He was out there showing forth the love of the Father. And he was out there and declaring every day that whatever he is doing is under the command of the Father. He was a carpenter. But as soon as he received the Holy Spirit, the dove, at his baptism, he was not working as a carpenter anymore. But that is the time when he became and filled with a divine reason, with the Logos from heaven. When he was filled with that, he became the true son of the Father. And from this time onwards, his ministry started. He was so strong at this time that even the devil could not tempt him in the desert for 40 days. And he was strong that he could stay without food and water 40 days. Because he had now the power of heaven inside. And the same example you see after the ascension, when the disciples were waiting in the upper room and the fiery tongues came. That is the same Logos came onto them. And then they were able to walk as Jesus did, doing miracles, raising the dead. They received the holy power. And I know in this time for the tribulation saints, these people will also receive the holy power. The bride will escape and then the holy power will come. will be settling on the people that will take leader positions in this remnant group. And everything what was done and written in the book of Acts will be repeated again, only on a much greater scale now, worldwide. And then afterwards we will all come together at Mount Zion, the holy mountain, not carved by human hands, but carved by Jesus Christ. And there we will be raptured into paradise, or some of us sealed as 144,000. And then we will continue our glorious work for the Father in the trumpet period, the true tribulation period, that will follow now the seventh seal. So, people are asking me, what's the time frame? When do you think the sixth seal is? Is the sixth seal not now? We have not even opened the first seal. How can people think that there is the sixth seal yet? They are confused because they only think there is one rapture. But there is not one rapture. There is one escape, what is actually the first rapture, but it's not a rapture, it's an escape, a vanishing. The escape of the bride, the first one. The second one is then at the sixth seal, what will be around 2024-2025. And this is a true rapture. You will be plucked away. And this is also in relation to Revelation 12 sign. And then we have a third one. That is at the time when Jesus will come down on the Mount of Olives. It will take the rest of the field, the corners of the field, and our Jewish brothers. And then Armageddon will come, and then a Jubilee year will come in the year 2033, and then the millennium will start. And the bride will not come down to earth for the millennium. And the bride has also nothing to do with the 144,000. The bride will go into the escape to the third heaven and will remain there until the bride will return with New Jerusalem after the end of the millennium. Just read in Revelation 22, read about it, that the New Jerusalem comes because she is the bride. Yes. It's also written that these people are the pillar in heaven. Heaven is a third heaven. There they are the pillars. And when the heaven comes down onto earth with the New Jerusalem, then they will return. So the bride is not part, has no work to do in the millennium. And they are not the 144,000. There's a lot of misunderstanding in all the teachings. The rapture, today I saw a video that said the rapture cannot be on the 17th. Yeah, of course not. Because on the 17th there will be definitely no rapture. The rapture is at the sixth seal. That is in the year 2024-2025. These people who make such videos, they have no understanding that there will be a threefold rapture idea behind. That there is an escape, a rapture, and another rapture. But it's very simple to see. Everything in the heavens is threefold. We have the Trinity and we have all the pattern, everything in threefold. I have made a whole video about that. Just look through it. It's a pattern in the Bible, it's called. And there you can see that everything is threefold. So now, we return to our topic today. I'm rambling a little bit along today. The kingdom heart. If you have not yet a kingdom heart, then please change your heart. And if you change to a kingdom heart, pray over it, be guided by the Holy Spirit, then you need to open your heart and do acts of loving kindness, because you are not part anymore of the world and out of Babylon. And if you have come out of the world and out of Babylon and are totally focusing on the heavenly kingdom, you must, and I tell you that very strongly, you must share your resources. You must support, you must help the needy, the nameless, the faces. You must look for the Lazarus at your gate. And everything that belongs to the heavenly kingdom, you must advance. And if you do not do this, then you do not have a kingdom heart. then you're still in the world. Where you say, oh, I cannot use my funds to help others, then you have still greed, and greed is part of the world, and greed is part of Babylon. Then you are not yet outside. When you are outside, you come, make donations, you come to help wherever you go to, but you do. And you do it daily. You make a daily sacrifice of love. That's the reason why we are called the daily sacrificers, because we make a daily sacrifice of love for the Father and in the name of the Father, and not in our name. Now you will ask, why have I never heard about your daily sacrifice? Because we are not Pharisees, and we are not standing in the front of the road and say, oh, today we have this good and this good. No, we do it in our groups, in our societies of the rose, in our assemblies of love and righteousness, not in the public. A kingdom heart is required. If you do not have it, then please acquire it. Acquire it through prayer. Pray that you want to change. Pray that you want to come out of the world. Pray about what I'm telling you. Pray about Triple Grace. Pray about my videos. Be guided by the Holy Spirit. Pray about that I'm asking you to support it and share it, and that you help with your donations and any other kind of financial support. Pray over it. Your guided help. If not, then maybe your path will be differently. But I know this is the path to Mount Zion. This is a straight and narrow path in the middle. This is the path of Jesus. This is a path that we all have to walk. This is a path where he walked with his cross. And this is a path where we will take our cross and walk that path into our glory, as Jesus also walked into his glory. So many patterns that are fulfilled in the Bible right now. So please, I am calling you as Michael, in love, out of this world and out of Babylon. Become a harvest worker. Become a true son and daughter of the Most High. Help us to bring it forth. Open up your heart. Do acts of loving kindness. Support us in any way you can. All the links are in the description box below. It is your time to step out. It is your time to walk through that open door and step onto the path. Path that Jesus has walked for us before. And now it's your time. Act, walk, and talk as he did, so that everything what is written and everything what is prophesied will be fulfilled. In Jesus' name I pray. I love you all so dearly, and I hope that you are listening and that you are following the advice I can give you. I was prepared through many hardships and many miseries over the last 10 years to give you these messages right now. It is not out of my own will. I'm not even a person for videos, as you can see many times. I'm just coming forth because I'm guided to do so, to help you onto the path. Because no sheep will be left. And we have to look for all the lost sheep and bring them into the fold and into the barn. We have to go and take the snake by the head to rescue the multitude clothed in white. This is our purpose and destiny, and yours too. The Lord is sending you these messages. It's a time to wake up, stand up, and walk out of the world and out of Babylon. Please listen and heed his warnings. The trumpets have sounded. The escape of the bride is at hand. The seals will be open. Do not enter the seal period alone. Where will you head to if disasters come and no government and no help of the world will be there? Where will you buy something if you have no mark of the beast? There's no way to buy anything. And nobody has called you to die as a murderer. This is not your destiny. Your destiny is to do the righteous deeds of the saints outside of the world and outside of Babylon, and to change your garments, your stained garments, into white clothes, so that you can enter the holy place, the place of the Father. So join us. Everything is there. Just do that step. Pray over it and join us. And help us to bring this message forth to all the nations. Share them through social media and with your friends and family. And come back again for the next video tomorrow. My name is Michael. May God bless you and your family abundantly. Maranatha.